protest them back in Jacksonville. Everyone doing something different. We were reacting to Lyles Thompson, the two of us. Now, if you guys know who he is, which I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys do, he was, of course, one of the guys in One Direction, one of the biggest boy bands still of all time. They were huge before the split. And it's funny because even when they split, they all went bigger than their own. They all had some good songs. So of course, Zayn was the first one to blow up. Then Harry came afterwards. Then I always thought Zayn was the best. Yes, guys, I listened to One Direction. I know, but if we're picking favorites, I gotta say Zayn was my favorite. But Zayn blew up, and Harry, and like they all had their own little thing of them blowing up. And I say it was kind of right because they were just so big as a group. I knew even once they separated, they all probably get bigger eventually. And I've listened mostly to Zayn's music and to Liam's music. I've listened mostly there. So I haven't really heard anything from like Lyles or Harry or the other one or Neil, I believe. Sorry, guys, I don't remember all the names of Neil, but I thought why not check him out and see if he's dope. So if you like, guys, please give me a thumbs up. Please hit the subscribe button down below for other reaction videos. Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section about this song. Do you like, you love, you want me to do more from him, or give me thoughts on any other artists you want to react to? And there will be a link down below to their video, but this is the lyric reel, so let's get into it, the two of us. But I say I like One Direction, and I really think they're all very talented, so I'm excited for this. It's been a minute since I called you, just to hear the answer phone. Yeah, I know that you won't get this, but I'll leave a message so I'm not alone. This morning I woke up still dreaming, with memories playing through my head. I really love his voice. I really love his voice, and I love the fact what the lyrics is doing. It's pretty cool. You'll never know how much I miss you. The day that they took you, I wish it was me instead. And he took you. Someone told me don't give up, you can do it day by day. And diamonds, they don't turn to dust or fade away. I really like this song. So I will keep you day and night, here until the day I die. I'll be living one life for the two of us. I will be the best of me, always keep you next to me. I'll be living one life for the two of us. Even when I'm alone, I know it won't be alone. Tattooed on my heart and the words in your favorite song. Hey. Oh, he said, "When she looking down, because he said, because I wouldn't say that when they took you away, does that mean that he passed away? Because he said looking down, but I love the way the news is feeling. I guess I'm assuming from what he said that she's probably passed away somehow. And like he said, you know, you love me. He said, you know, diamonds don't turn to dust, they don't fade away. He's like, I'm gonna live my life the best of me for the two of us, and I really love it. It's very beautiful. And what I'm assuming that she's probably that the girl he's talking about probably passed away." And that he's saying, you know, even though you're gone, I still really have like the tattoos, like the lyrics of your favorite song. Like I still always remember you. It's I really like it. It's very tear jerking. I can feel your blood run through me. You're written in my DNA. Looking back in every mirror. I know you've been waiting. I'll see you again. I'm smiling because I really like this song. I love the whole meme, but it sounds beautiful. I love the fact he's saying, even though you're gone, I'm still going to live my life for the two of us. Like you say, I have the lyrics of your favorite song, Tattoo on My Heart, this in the arm, basically Tattoo on My Heart. And like, I love the way he said, diamonds don't turn to dust and they'll fade away. And I just really love what he's saying about, because it's kind of, it's just tear-jerking, because he's really, you're feeling like the passion and the love that he has for this girl. And that's all I'll say, like, when it comes to singing, whether it's pop, R&B, jazz, rock, whatever, when you can feel the passing and just the love in the song of the person singing, you really feel like they're singing about this girl that really happened to them. That's to me knows that they're a great singer. That's a great song, because when you can feel that passing, it kind of hits you emotionally. That's why I know it's such a great song. And this was kind of different. It really hit me because he's really telling his fans about this girl that, you know, that's probably, from, I'm assuming, probably passed away somehow, or maybe she had an accident or something. And he said, they took you away. And he said, you're looking down on me. So all of a sudden, my life took a foolish because of that. And so he's probably telling girls about some girl that he was really in love with that ended up passing away. And he's sitting there and he's writing his letters. He's writing these letters to her that are probably not going anywhere, but it makes him feel still like he's connected to her. And that he's living his life the best that he can. He's living his life with two of them. Because, you know, it's funny, though, because you're going to love somebody and that person dies. And unless you're, like, super old, you still have the ability to find love. And I believe you can love more than just one person. So he's like, you know, a lot of people, like, they let themselves get down. They let themselves get, you know, drowned. And most he's like, no, I'm still going to live my life. You know, you're gone for the both of us, because I know that's what you want me to do. You don't want me to feel sad and depressed and stay inside all day thinking about you. So I really like that. It really kind of hits you in the feel a little bit. Sorry, guys. Let's finish the song. Though. I've really been enjoying it. Thank you. Well, guys, that's the end of the video. I really like it. I love the song. I love the meaning behind it. I love the way, I love how he sounded. I love like the whole lyrics videos. Like, it's like him writing what he's feeling about in these lyrics. You see him like he's been doing it for days. You see the different cups of coffee that's there. So he's probably been up nights just writing his letter and just pouring how he feels to his girl, even though she's not there anymore. So I'm assuming that she's probably passed away. That's what I'm assuming. Even though he's like, she's up ahead looking down, he's still writing these letters to her, and he's still writing this how he feels, and pretty much expressed that even though you're gone, you'll always be in my heart, you'll never go anywhere. Like you say, I have a lyrics of your favorite song tattooed in my heart, that you know, diamonds never turn to dust on their fade away, meaning that your memory will never leave my head, will never leave his heart, will never leave his head, he will never forget her, she'll always be there, she's like a precious diamond. And she will always shine in his heart. And just the meme out, so I really just love it. And so, definitely a great song. That's what I said. That's why I really like One Direction. Despite people say they were all very talented. And that's why, like I said, even back then, even when the group broke up, I knew they were all going to go and do the big thing because they were all very talented in their own right. That's why SoundCloud was a genius, though, to put them all together as a group and make become One Direction. That way they all got big. Because it helps when you're a really famous group and you split up. Because even when you're a group and you have fans of the group, like, there's still a lot of fans who I each one of their favorite. Like, in One Direction, there were a lot of girls that who Louis was their favorite, or Lyles was their favorite, or Zayn was their favorite, or Harry was their favorite, or Neil was their favorite. So That's what I think it was very smart to put them in a group. So even now when they're separated, they still when they separate, they still have their own personal fan groups. But like I said, I really haven't listened to One Directions besides like Liam and Zayn. But I really like those. This song was really great. I thought it was very beautiful. Anyway, guys, that's the interview. If you guys like, again, drop me a thumbs up. I very much appreciate it. Hit the subscribe button, guys. I'm sure that'd be awesome. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below about the songs you like it, you love it, about the videos you like it, you love it. Get just some other songs you can react to from other RRs or even more from Laos or even one of the other Red Directs, even one of the other guys from One Direction. Let me know. I will jump right on it. And again, there will be a link down below to the recent video. But I really love the song. I thought the video was beautiful. It went perfectly along with the song, even though it's a lyric video. But anyway, like, again, guys, I correct and I'm out. Peace.